king, great and powerful. I know how to take care of those bad people until I met Jesus. Now he says I'm supposed to love as he loves, be compassionate like he is, obey, be just like him. So I've had to surrender, had to give all that zealot type fire away. But then he talks about somebody being a betrayer. And then it kind of makes me want to think, well, maybe I know how to take care of a traitor. Maybe it's Matthew. Maybe it's that big fisherman over there. Or maybe it's me. Lord, is it I?
Grateful to my brother Andrew here for introducing me to the Master. My life has never been the same since. I remember one of the turning points, early experience for me, when Andrew and I were out fishing. We'd been fishing all night, hadn't caught a thing. And as day was breaking, we heard someone call from the shore, and upon closer inspection, behold, there was Jesus. He was calling to us. He said, cast your net on the deep side. He's a carpenter, telling us how to catch fish. But he speaks with authority, and as silly as I felt, we threw the nets in the deep end. And to my amazement, we caught more fish than the net could hold. We had to call to neighboring vessels to come help us to haul in the catch. It was at that moment that I knew in my heart who he was. And when we got to the shore, I fell at his feet and cried, depart from me, for I am a sinful man. He raised me up and said, Peter, to that point I'd been Simon, but Peter, I'm going to make you fishermen. From this point on, you'll be catching men. And I've done my best. I remember one time when, after a long day of ministry, we were all talking amongst ourselves, and there was some chatter going on among the crowds about who he really was. Believe it or not, some thought that he was Moses come back to life, Elijah. Jesus steps in and says, I've heard them too, but who do you say that I am? Without hesitation, I stood up and said, I believe that you're the Christ. You're the Son of the living God. He said, you didn't come up with that yourself. The Holy Spirit, my Father in heaven, has told you that. And that warms my heart. But that smile didn't last long, because later, as he was talking about this trip to Jerusalem, where he was going to suffer at the hands of evil men, I protested. You shouldn't go. And he said, get behind me, Satan. My brethren call me the big fisherman. But in his presence, I feel very small and unworthy. Now we're sitting around this table, and he says one of us is going to betray him. After all this time, spending time together and with him, that one of us would betray him? It wouldn't be me. I said, no, not I. I will follow you till death. But he tells me that by morning, when the rooster crows, that I will deny him. And not once, but three times. But to betray him, I believe is every word. I believe that he's right. One of our number is going to betray him. And he could tell us who it is. Lord, tell us who it is so I can defend you. I would pierce him through the heart. It's possible it would be me. After all, I'm going to deny him. If I deny him, what will he do? Will he deny me? Will he disown me? I can't help but wonder. Lord, is it I?
Dolorosa, Tristia, Jerusalem. over 2,000 years, many miles separate us from Jerusalem. But the scene that night probably hasn't changed dramatically. Like the disciples of old, all of us composed the church of God. Jesus was present in that upper room, and he's present here today. And the Lord is just as interested in our spiritual well-being. And yet that same question can also confront us, maybe even haunt us at times. Am I the one? Could I have betrayed him? And often that answer is sadly, yes. All of you have gone astray. That's what the prophet Isaiah said. We all like sheep have turned aside to our own selfish ways. Yet we still have hope in our hearts.